flying the friendly skies as a United Airlines pilot was a rare accomplishment for a female in the late 1970s. Susan Arthurs was living that dream. Breaking workplace barriers and proving she belonged was all part of the journey.
I was their eighth woman pilot. That at the time was out of 6,000 pilots. So it was a pretty remarkable place to be at that time and very exciting for me. It was a whole new world, obviously.
With her future as carefully plotted as one of her flight plans, an unexpected event brought her world crashing down. Only 39 years old, Arthur's life changed forever when a seizure struck in the middle of the night.
It was a horribly difficult situation. In many ways, it's embarrassing to admit how my identification was tied up into being an airline pilot and being a pilot. I had a little airplane of my own. And overnight, I went from being a very independent, self-sufficient, accomplished woman to being totally dependent. It was a terrible shock to my system.
Whatever affliction had struck, she was ready to persevere and resume work. She enjoyed a lengthy period of time without incident and planned to attempt a return to flying. Unfortunately, another seizure struck.
I am one of the fortunate ones who have epilepsy, who has total 100% control of seizures with a fairly low dose of medication. So in that vein, I'm lucky, very lucky. And in the end, I can remember the day I actually had to admit to the word epilepsy and think about moving on from there.
Transitioning to her new life tested her resolve. It included a 37,000-mile trek across the country in her RV. With her dog as company, she explored the country and searched her soul, finally deciding her next chapter would be earning a graduate degree in aviation.
There were good people in Warrensburg. It kind of felt more like home. Dr. Herrine was great, both as an advisor for the program and then a mentor when I started teaching later on, and made many, many, many good friends. I call many of them my Missouri family. I ended up staying in Warrensburg 12 years. A number of other things happened, but I did get my master's degree in 1 year.
Arthur successfully redefined her life and career following her diagnosis, working for a number of years as a faculty member at UCM's Department of Aviation. Her life, however, was busy beyond her aviation career. Before reaching Central, a doctor had urged her to use her expertise and personal experience with epilepsy to take awareness of the disease and research efforts to a higher level.
When I went to see a neurologist in Kansas City, he showed me the work he was doing on epilepsy research and predicting seizures and then intervene in the seizure with the treatment to stop it before it ever got started. And then he suggested I start a grassroots group for epilepsy research. And we got an organization going called the Alliance for Epilepsy Research.
As the work of the Alliance began, Arthurs and her team encountered a major barrier: the lack of public understanding of the disease and its effects.
And so we stepped back and thought, well, we're gonna have to educate the public first before we can go asking them for contributions to support this research. And thus the documentary, It Is Epilepsy, was started and was about a 10-year project in the end.
As the videotaping of the documentary concluded, the funding for the project had been exhausted. Production ceased, and the video likely would have gone unfinished without the aid of Doug Underwood.
Once I looked at all the footage, that I knew we had to finish, we had to complete it. It was an important piece of work, maybe the most important piece I'll ever work on. She made a lot of trips back and forth between Michigan and here. Whenever I had an opportunity to work on it, spring break, summers.
Underwood was impressed with Arthur's dedication to the project and her willingness to be involved throughout the post-production process.
Yeah, I couldn't have asked for a better person to have worked with on this, and she knew what she wanted, and we set about getting that done. We had to shoot some extra things. She had great ideas, very intelligent woman who I think ultimately ended up enjoying the process.
The documentary was submitted to more than 60 film festivals and won numerous awards and recognition.
Sometimes things are stuck back in the dark, and it opened eyes. Making more people aware that this is something that needs to be addressed on a larger scale.
One of my very best friends came up to me and said, you know, I had epilepsy as a kid, but he said, I never until this day told anybody I had it. He said, my parents told me not to tell anybody. And he said, you just didn't do that. You just didn't tell. And I was stunned because I had never known that.
Arthur's now lives in Michigan, enjoying time with her family and long walks with her dog, Belle.
What? You ready for dinner?
The Alliance continues, often serving to plan and host international workshops on seizure prediction. Arthur's love of aviation still burns brightly, leading her to create an innovative educational program.
I started a little company of my own called Blue Skies Ideas and developed a series of books and CDs of all kinds of activities and resources for aviation and space activities for use in the elementary and high schools. It was a wonderful thing to do, and it's so much fun seeing all these activities for all different subject areas and grade levels.
The flight plan for Susan Arthur's life may have started as a nonstop, with no turbulence expected. Successfully navigating uncharted territory has ultimately taken her on an even more amazing journey.
Oftentimes, life takes us down paths that, you know, we're almost along for the ride. It's not of our directing or choosing. That's kind of sometimes how I feel about all of this. I've just happened to be in the right place at the right time and went with it. And it's worked.
Congratulations, Susan. Couldn't come to a more deserving person. Thank you for letting me be a part of the work on the epilepsy documentary.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome 2014 UCM Distinguished Alumni Award for Service winner, Ms. Susan Arthurs.